Hey folks, so I was going to do an update on my Tiger that I'm building for the Wardstone Facebook group build that's going on for the Eastern Front. This is a Leningrad Tiger, the first engagement that they had. It's one of the two that I'm building, in case you haven't watched any of the other videos that I did. I'm not going to go any more detail than that. You can go back and watch. So anyway, I want to just show you what I'd done on this thing. I did a bit of an experiment on this thing. Now, a lot of times in the past, I've done the suspension on tigers. I've done on a panther and a king tiger as well. In a, I guess, somewhat unusual way. It's not my way at all. I got it from a book that I have, where the suspension is all done in one piece, and you paint it separately and weather it separately and stuff like that. And you can do it with either individual link tracks, or you can do it with link and length tracks. But I've never tried to do it with rubber band tracks before. But anyway, so you basically, you just mold them all as one piece. I'll show you. Now, I had these done in another video where I was weathering them like this, and I demonstrated how to weather them basically in a previous video. But this time I did it with some magic tracks because I wanted to see if I could do it. And you can. And you get the sag in there and all that other stuff. And they're still even workable, as you can see. Right? And when you put them on, well, it takes too long to put them on, but they're even workable on the Tiger as well, as you can see. So now it's actually very simple to build these things. Basically, you build your suspension, so you get your workable arms and stuff like that on your machine. This works on tigers, works on king tigers, works on panthers. I have not tried it on panther or panzer fours or panzer threes or Shermans or Cromwells or any other vehicles yet, though some of those might not work at all. Some it might work completely. I think you could do it on a Sherman. It might be a bit tricky, but I think you can do it. I know you can do it on a Panzer 38. I know you can do it on the Panther and the King Tiger, because I've done it. The Panzer 4 might be a bit tricky, but not impossible. I can see in my head, I can see how you could do it too. You have to plan it out before you do it. But I plan on doing it as I build vehicles of these types over time, just to see if I can. So, but I wanted to see if I could do it with the rubber band tracks. Now, these are DS tracks, dragon styrene tracks. Most people don't like these. I don't mind them. They don't bother me too much. I find them easier to work with because I hate building tracks most of the time. They really fuck me off. So, anyway, so I decided that I wanted to give these a run. So basically, all I do is I build up the suspension like this. So, and you know, if they're not workable, I try to make them workable if I can. And making them workable sometimes is a bit of a chore, sometimes not. In this case, I had to make the sprocket mount for the transmission hub there. I had to make it workable. And so that it had an axle that slid into the hole. When you first get this, it's the other way around. The axle sticks out and it's not very stable. So I had to reverse it so it's tighter. So I had to make my own. And that's not a big deal. I basically cut off the plug that's on there and then drill it out and then add my own to the inside of this with some super glue and some sprue glue to give it some strength, and then that's it. And I put a rubber grommet. I glue it on the inside to give it a solid, tighter fit on the inside. It's like a washer. So, but anyway, so you mount your wheels on, right, on your Tiger, so they're all on, but don't glue them on. You glue your wheels together and you put them on, and then you get to wait for the glue to dry, and then you put them on. If you don't, they'll glue themselves to the torsion bars. You don't want to do that, because then you break them, which is what I did on my last Tiger. So, I do that a lot. So anyway, So anyway, so you get your wheels on, and then you take your rubber bands, in this case, the Dragon styrene ones, and you put them on. And then you use good old fashioned, to me, extra thin. So I took a bunch of clothespins and I jammed them in over here, over the top of this, and then I flowed, to me, extra thin into where all the wheels contact the track on the top and the bottom. And then I weighted it down, right? I had this side supported, and then I just weighted it down for about 20 minutes. And then I flipped it over and I did the inside, right? And they did the same thing. I weighted it down, waited about 20 minutes. Basically, I went over and I did some work on the computer. And then I came back and it was done. And I did the same thing on the other side. And then the grand experiment is trying to take them off. If they come off, then you did your job. If they don't come off, well, then you're going to have to paint them while they're still on the vehicle for now. Which also is not a bad thing because you can still do it. It's actually not exactly wrong to do that on a model. Some people say, oh, you can't do that. It's impossible. That's bullshit. Don't listen to people talk that way. They're crazy. I've done it at least 20 times, I think. So, but anyway, so yeah, so you can pop these back on. There, ta-da. And Bob's your uncle. And you can just pop them off to weather them. Painting is easy. You prime the whole thing, prime the wheel assembly is one piece. And I usually do it in black, and then I take my base color for the vehicle, and I spray it in here and on both sides, because I have it off the vehicle, it's in my hand. And I just leave the tracks in black. And then if there's any more camo work, I do that, you know, like the lines and bands or whatever that you're going to do to the wheels. And then I come back and do the detail. So I come back in and I cut the rubber for the road wheels, which on these is a bit tedious because there's rubber on them. But, you know, you don't have to do the outside unless you really want to go crazy and do the inside. You can. I usually do the two lead wheels because you can see them. But I don't usually do the inside here because you can't see them. But if you want to be really anal, go ahead. And then I cut in with my, just a paintbrush, I do the tracks just in flat black, and, or it doesn't matter, you actually flat or gloss, it doesn't make any difference because when you matte coat the whole thing, it changes all that anyway. There's no difference between flat and gloss when it comes to modeling armor, because when you flat or gloss it anyway, it's going to change all that. So this is, I've never understood why people get their knickers in a twist over that whole concept. It doesn't make any sense to me. I've never bothered paying any attention to that. It doesn't matter if it's satin gloss or matte. When it comes to the paint, it's the grand effect at the end that's what matters, and that's going to be under a matte or a semi-gloss finish anyway when you're done. So anyway, that's another rant. So that's basically it in a nutshell. So this thing, I kind of wasn't really paying attention to the instructions when I was building this thing, and I was watching a movie while I was doing it. So I slapped the hull together, and I had the bow plate on, the rear plate, and I even put the top plate here on, and then I realized I hadn't put any of the suspension arms. None of the torsion bars were in. I was like, ah, for shit's sake. So then I had to put them in through here, and that was a little tricky. It was possible. It's just a pain in the ass. I had to use my really long, to me, a square tweezers to put them in there, but the Revell Contacta, I'm glad I have this. It's got a really long needle, right? So it allowed me to get the glue in there. Yeah. Oops. Oh, I wasn't paying attention. So, but this hull went together a lot better than the previous one. It had the same problems that the previous one did, just that I remembered them this time. Required the same amount of clamping, but the hull is in better condition. It doesn't look so banana boat. So, but anyway, I don't know. I just thought you guys might find that interesting, be a bit handy or something like that. If you're going to be using Dragon styrene tracks or rubber band tracks, and you previously had a hatred for the things, maybe this will make you realize that they're actually not that bad. As long as they haven't oxidized and turned to cracker crumbs, because they do that Sometimes these things, before you paint them, they'll get all of a sudden really brittle in the box and just be completely useless. I've had that happen to me. I don't know why that happens. Some kind of chemical reaction. They'll get all oily and then they'll be like cracker crumbs. You can crush them in your hand like crackers. It's really weird. And this also, when you do it this way, there's less chance of the paint flaking and falling off when you're working on them, because they're all in one piece and you're handling them less, and you don't have to stretch them and pull on them in order to get them back on the vehicle. So, and it's also easier to, as you can see, get the sag back in there. That's actually the proper sag for a Tiger. So, anyway, that's all I got for this, I think. I still have quite a bit of work left to do on this one here, and I'm still waiting on the other kit that I have on order for this build. I've actually now decided I'm going to do a second build for this group build. It's sitting behind me on the thing waiting. Once I finish this Tiger, I think I'm going to probably pause this build and start working on another build that I really have been procrastinating on the shelf for a while. So I got to get to it. So, one of the things that's kind of annoying about this kit, you always end up with a third track that has no home. I built this kit before, so I've already used the other one. So I have no mate to this. It's kind of annoying. This kit uses, it's called mirrored tracks, and they give you the option of using the regular paired ones. So, and this is the paired version if you want to do the paired tracks. So I don't have a mate to go with it. It's kind of annoying. So, but anyway, that's all I got, I guess. You guys be good. Keep your stick on the ice. Bye for now.